Hello students, today we are going to start the chapter Real Numbers. Okay, this is the second chapter of algebra, much weightage for your exams, very important for your 9th and 10th standard algebra basics. Okay, so first we'll learn the what are real numbers. I've already discussed number systems before, right? Number system is divided into two, real numbers and complex numbers, right? Complex number is not into the pictures for 9th and 10th standard both, real numbers. So what is the first part we learned in sets was real numbers. Real numbers are again divided into rational and irrational. That we will go on further. Now first we are studying what is a real number. Real numbers, the number represented on the number line are called as real numbers. What is real number? The numbers which can be represented on a number line. So there are n numbers you can represent on a number line. You can start from 0. Towards your left will be your negative numbers and towards your right will be the positive numbers. Okay, so all your rational, irrational numbers, your fractions, your decimals, your whole, your natural numbers, everything comes under the real numbers. So you can say real numbers is a universal set, sabse bada. Okay, abhi humne properties learn karte hain. If a, b, c are rational numbers, so all rational numbers are real numbers. Okay, so if a, b, c are rational numbers, these are the four properties: commutative property, associative, identity, and inverse. Okay, what is commutative property? It's simple. Addition and multiplication ke rules alag hote hain. Maine hamesha tumko bola hai. Addition and subtraction goes hand in hand. Multiplication and division goes hand in hand. So, dono ka properties alag hota hai. So, in addition, if a plus b is there, it is equal to b plus a. So simply if I write say 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2, answer you get is 5 in both the cases. Clear? You can say a plus b is equal to b plus a. Second property says a plus b whole bracket plus c is equal to a b plus c the whole bracket. Let us assume, we have assumed the values a as 2, b as 3 and c as 4. Only this values we are going to take for all the properties. So let us, you know Bormas, first bracket open karna. So 2 plus 3 kitna hota hai? 5. 5 plus 4?
9.
Abhi ye pehle bracket solve karna padega. So 3 plus 4 kitna hota hai? 7. 7 plus 2 is 9. Both the cases you are getting the answer same?
Yes.
Commutative, associative. Next is identity. What is identity? A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus A is equal to A. So if 2 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 2 is equal to
2.
Inverse. Inverse ka kya matlab hota hai? Ulta. Plus A ka value kya hoga?
Minus
A. Theek hai? Inverse matlab ulta. Plus minus A is
minus
C. 2 plus minus 2. 2 ka ulta kya hua?
Minus 2.
2 plus minus is minus. So 2 minus 2 becomes your 0. So if you're taking inverse, you'll get the answer 0. Now same we'll see in the multiplication property. A into B is equal to B into A. Simple. 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2. Which is equal to
6.
Both answers. Here also same thing. I have solved the bracket first. B into C. What is B into C? 12. 12 into 2 is 24. Here also 2 into 3 is 6. 6 into 4 is 24. Both cases I'll get the answer same. In identity, A into 1 is equal to 1 into A is equal to A. 2 into 1 or 1 into 2, you get the answer to itself. Inverse. Inverse matlab A ka ulta kya hoga abhi? Minus A nahi hoga. Multiplication mein ulta kya hota hai? Division. So 1 upon A. So A cancel ho jata hai. Answer 1. So simple, I'll solve 2. 2 ka ulta kya ho gaya? Inverse 1 upon 2. And hence you get the answer 1. So come to page number 22. You all remember terminating, non-terminating type letter in the standard of second chapter.
Yes.
So terminating. What is terminating? Simple English. Terminating ka matlab kya hota hai? Terminating means stop.
Stop.
Jiska remainder zero aata hai. Usko kya bolte hai? Terminating. Non-terminating kya hota hai?
Goes on continuing.
It goes on continuing. It can be recurring. You all remember recurring?
Dash. first example we are having, we are supposed to solve first, we are supposed to find whether it is terminating or non-terminating. So what will I do in this case? I'll divide. नीचे जो होता है वो divisor, the upper is division, 2. This is greater, so I'll put a decimal, 0.0520. I get the remainder 0. So this is terminating.
Yes.
So I'll write here 2/5 is equal to 0.4. Okay. Second says -7/64. Now I'll discard the negative sign first. Then I'll again, after getting an answer, I'll put a negative sign again. So how will I solve this? Sixty-four is your divisor, 7 is your dividend. 0.0 64 8 64 1 64. What is the remainder?
6.
Decimal 0 64. So what will I do? Again 0 and 0. Find out the table. 9 zar, of course 9 zar. So what is 9 zar? 64 9 zar is how much? Find it up faster.
576.
9 zar is 576. What is your remainder?
4.
24. Again 0. Find out the next number will be 3. 64 into 3. 12. 18, 19, 192. 3s are 192. What is your remainder? This is 8, this is 13 and this goes. And then 48. Again, 0. How much? The next number will be 7. 63 into 7. 21. 48 plus
44.
Sorry, 48. 28. 42 plus 2? 448. What is your remainder? 248. 7. 2. 3. 4. 3. 3. Okay, this is how much? 64 into 5. 27. Yeah, 32. So remainder becomes 0 here.
Yes.
So this is my terminating. So I'll write here. I'll now put a negative sign. -7/64. The answer is -0.109355. Okay, this is my answer. Let us take an example of non-terminating. Let us see the first one I just put. (17/36). Let us start. 36 is your divisor and dividend is 17. So 36, 0.0. Let us take 36 into 4. 24, 12, and 14. That's 144. 4s are 144. 6 and this reduces 6, yeah, 2. 0 again. 36 into 6, 36, 6, 18, 18 plus 2 and 6. Lesser, we'll divide, we'll take a greater number. 7, 42, 25, 25, yeah, this is the correct one. 7 and 2, 52. Remainder will be 8. 0. 36 into 2, you know, 72?
Yes.
I hope you know that is
yes.
72. 8. Again 0. So 2, 2, 2 will be recurring?
Yes.
So this is?
Non-terminating.
Why? Since your remainder is not 0, you will get the answer as non-terminating. So I'll write here. First example as 17/36 is equal to 0.472. Since only 2 is recurring, I'll just put a dot on 2. And please put the dot which is visible to the examiner. Okay? Clear? Now I'll give you the one example to solve this one. 56 upon 37. Solve this. Get me the answer. The first sum which we are going to learn now, we have already done terminating and non-terminating. Okay? How we are supposed to find that? By division method. Okay? If the remainder is 0, it is terminating. If it is not, it is a non-terminating. Now we are going to do, how are we supposed to express a recurring decimal in P upon Q form? This P upon Q is nothing but a fraction.
Yes.
Okay? A decimal we are supposed to convert in a fraction. Students, if it was like 0.2, it was very simple. We can write as 2 upon 10. Okay? Decimal ke baad kitne numbers hai? 1 hai. So upon 10 kar dene ka. Okay? But it is not simple. They are recurring decimal. कौन से है रेकरिंग डेसिमल, तो इसको कैसे सॉल्व करेंगे? वेरी वेरी सिंपल स्टूडेंट्स, दिस आर 3 मार्क्स सम्स, 3 मार्क्स, यू कैन क्रैक इट, वेरी सिंपल. सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद दिस सॉल्यूशन, लेट x बी इक्वल टू 0.777 रेकरिंग. स्टूडेंट्स कैन आई सिंपली राइट 0.7 डैश ऊपर डॉट, उतना ही रह करो, इतना लंबा क्यों लिखो? ओके, नाउ आफ्टर डेसिमल हाउ मेनी डिजिट्स आर देयर?
वन
डिजिट. सो वन डिजिट मींस आई विल मल्टीप्लाई बोथ साइड्स बाय 10. ओके, सो ऑल राइट, सो व्हाट वी गेट, 10 into x is 10x, is equal to 10 into 0.7 recurring. How will I write the answer? See, students, when I am writing, I am multiplying recurring decimal with 10, this is nothing but 10 into 0.777 dot 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 dot. Okay, when I multiply, the decimal will shift one more place. So this will be 7.7 recurring or not? That is, can I write a 7.7 dot? Understood?
Yes.
Okay? This is a simple solving. But how to solve here is, directly shift the decimal, that is 7, and whatever is after decimal, write it after decimal. Matlab jo number hai, usko 7 likh do, aur decimal ke baad jo bhi hai, wo waisa ka waisa drop down karo. समझ में आया ये वर्किंग प्रॉब्लम? अगर नहीं समझ में आता है तो कर लेना, इट्स ओके. रेदर देन डूइंग रॉन्ग, इट इज ओके टू डू अ वर्किंग प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो हाउ विल यू सॉल्व? व्हाट एवर डिजिट्स आर रिपीटिंग आफ्टर डेसिमल यू राइट दैट, एंड देन आफ्टर डेसिमल यू ड्रॉप डाउन द सेम, नो इश्यूज. ओके, सो आई हैव गॉट दिस. नाउ व्हाट इज माय पर्पस टू गेट रीड ऑफ डेसिमल? क्या करना है? रेकरिंग डेसिमल को मेरे को फ्रैक्शन के फॉर्म में लाना है. अभी डेसिमल के बाद क्या ये चीज नहीं चाहिए? कौन सी चीज नहीं चाहिए? ये वाला डेसिमल वाला, ये पूरा पार्ट नहीं चाहिए. तो इसको कैंसिल करने के क्या करना पड़ेगा? दिस इज माय फर्स्ट वन, दिस इज माय सेकंड वन. इफ आई सबट्रैक्ट, यस परफेक्ट, इफ आई सबट्रैक्ट दिस एंड दिस, विल आई गेट रिड ऑफ दैट? सो हाउ विल आई डू? सबट्रैक्टिंग टू फ्रॉम वन. Subtracting 1 from, what do we get? 10x minus, left hand side will be subtracted from the left hand side, and right hand side will be subtracted from the right hand side. 7.7 recurring subtracted by 0.7 recurring. Let us solve it. 7.7 recurring minus 0.7 recurring.
Seven.
This is Gaya?
Yeah.
What remains is?
7.
10x minus x is nothing but 9x. This is nothing but coefficient is 1. Okay, so I'll write here 9x is equal to
7.
Got rid of decimal. What I'm supposed to do? X is equal to
7 upon 9.
X was my assumption. Samme diya hua nahi tha. It was my assumption. So x ki jagah what will I write? What was my x? 0.777 recurring is equal to 7 upon 9. P upon Q form. Fraction mein aa gaya. Have I converted the recurring into a P upon Q form, that is into fraction? Okay. Now let us do the next. Okay. What is the question? 7.529. 529 is recurring. So how will I write? Let x be equal to, same procedure. X be equal to 7.529 recurring. So can I write as 7.529 dash. Perfect. Now after decimal, how many digits are there?
Three.
So how many zeros?
Thousand.
Three. That is 1000. I'll multiply both sides by 1000. So 1000 x is equal to 1000 into 7.529 recurring. So students, same application here. After decimal, whatever were the digits I wrote it. So same here. Decimal ke baad jo bhi digits hai, kya karoge? 7 to decimal ke pehle hai. So that is not counted. After decimal, how? What is there?
529.
So 529 I'll write. And decimal ke baad, same thing. Clear? Okay? 1000x will remain as it is. Now this becomes my equation 2 and this becomes my equation 1. What am I supposed to get rid of? My decimal 529 recurring. I'll subtract from here.
Yes.
It will get rid of?
Yes.
So subtracting, same thing. Subtracting 1 from
2.
2. Thousand x minus one x or x, whatever. Students now have a habit of writing it x only. Mm. Okay. 7529.529 recurring minus 7.529 recurring. Now 1000x minus 1x will be about, what is 1000 minus 1? 999. Now let us solve this. 7529.529 recurring subtracted by 7.529 recurring. I hope students you all know how to place the values. Place values, okay? You are not supposed to write it here. Decimal, decimal ke saath, numbers, numbers ke saath. This is unit and this is also unit. So we'll write that way. This is gone, all gone. 9 minus 7 is 2. 2, 5 and 6. Students, many tend to write, they don't solve this and they tend to write 7529, that is what. Many make mistakes, so students never make the mistakes. Because here, decimal ke pehle koi digit nahi tha. So same ka same answer aa gaya, like decimal ke pehle digits hoga, so same answer nahi aayega. So what I am supposed to write? 7522. Can I write as simple as x is equal to 7522 upon 999. Now x was my assumption. What is actually in the sum? This. So I'll write answer as 7.529529 is equal to 7522 upon 999. Very simple. What if? How to solve? Again we'll go. First take is at x. Okay. Then what are you supposed to do after decimal? How many are digits? If it is 1, you multiply by 10, if it's 2, 100, 3, 1000. More than 1000, it won't be there. Then you get the answer subtracting equation 1 from
2.
And then you get rid of the fraction, sorry, decimal, and then you have to solve it. Very simple. You have 3 marks now. Okay, now start with this one. This is exercise 2.1. Third sum. Third or fifth sum. Start. I'm keeping the pattern same and start. We will now move to exercise 2.1 on page number 21. Okay, we'll start solving 13 upon 5. So what are we supposed to do? Whatever we have done in the solved example in the earlier one. What are we supposed to do? Terminating or non-term? What is terminating?
Remainder
0 is case terminating. If the remainder is not 0, it is a non-terminating. So we'll do the first one. 5 and 13. 5, 2's are 10. 3. Decimal 0. 5, 6 are 13. And it is 0. So this is terminating. So I will write the answer. 13 upon 5 is equal to 2.6. It is terminating. Decimal. Okay, so if it is a non-terminating, you're right, it is a non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, so second one will do 11 and 2. Decimal, I have to put it 0. 11, 1s are 11. 9 and 11, 8s are 88. 2, 0, again 1. And 11.
9.
We'll go on.
20.
Okay. This will go on. That is, I'll write answer 2 upon 11 is equal to 0.18 recurring. It is non terminating recurring decimal. We'll do the next one. 16 and 29. 16 ones are 16. 13.0. We'll do it further. 16 what? 5. 16 5 is 18. You want
67 is
16. 16 8 is how much? 16 8 is 128. 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 16 8 is 16 is equal to 1.8125.
So what is this? It is a terminating decimal. Can you do this two further?
Yes.
Okay. Very simple. Very simple. Nothing to do. Simple division method. Now students, when you are getting a non-terminating recurring type, until and unless your digit starts repeating, you are supposed to divide till that point. Yes. Okay. In the earlier sum also we had done 10937 something. Okay. Yes. We did till 6. And the 7th digit was recurring. So till the next digit you are not getting the recurring, you are supposed to divide it continuously. Okay. After 6 probably you will get a recurring one. Okay. So this 2 you can do it.
Yes.
Okay. Fine. So we are going to the second sub-question.
Yes.
What is the question? Write the following rational number in decimal form.
in decimal form means what? Again we have to do the same method as we have done the first sub question. Divide. Now students, let me clear it out. Whenever there is zero in the denominator, it is very simple to divide. How? We will do it as 127 upon 2 into 100. Separate the zeros. Okay? Because once you are doing 200 and 127, it will be too long. So separate the zeros. Now you are supposed to divide only 127 upon 2. So what is your answer for 127 upon 2 is 6, 12, 7, 3,
6, 1, 5.
And 0. So how will I write the answer is 63.5. Iska answer kya aaya? 63.5. And the denominator still remains as 100. Now, whenever decimals are in, whenever zeros are in denominator, your decimal point will shift to the left hand side. If it is multiplication, it will shift towards the right hand side. If it is division, it will move towards left hand side. Two places. One place and two places. So it will be 0.635. Very simple. So whenever there are zeros, we are supposed to separate those zeros. So your division will be very simple. Okay, next we will do. This has, we have no option, we have to do it that the same method, that is 99 upon 25. 0.0, 99 into how much? 99, 2s will be 198. What will be a remainder? 52. 0. 99 into 5. 99 into 5 is how much? 495. Answer will be 25. 0. 99 into again 2. 198. Remainder 52. Recurring?
Yes.
So what will you do? 99 upon 25 upon 99 is equal to 0.25 recurring. You are supposed to divide the further in the same method. Okay, same here, what will we do? 7 upon 23 is this. 7, these are 20, 1, 2, 0. 7, these are 14, 6, 0, 7.
7,
8 are 4 and 0, 7, 5 are 35, 5 and 0, 7, 7 are 49, 1 and 0, 7, 1s are 7, 3 and 0, 4s are 20, 2 and 0, 2s are. So, as I have told you, 7th digit you will get as record. Okay? You will never get more than 6. So I'll write 23 upon 7 is equal to 3.285714. Okay? Will you do the other one? Okay, very, very simple. Question number 3. This is the P upon Q form. You are supposed to write the decimals in P upon Q form. The same method. What are you supposed to do? Let x is equal to 0.37. How many digits after decimal?
2.
2. So multiplying both sides by
100.
100.
So it will be 100. X is equal to 100 into 0.37. So this will be what? I'm supposed to write the digits. 37.37 recurring. Same as it is. Okay? Because the decimal will move two places. So 100. This is my first. This is my second. Subtracting. 1 from 2. 100x minus x is equal to 37.37 recurring. minus 0.37. x minus x will be 99x. So when you subtract it, you will get rid of this and you will get the answer as 37. Recurring minus 0.37 recurring. Students always have a habit of doing this because in the other sums we have seen that the answer won't be same always. So you will get the answer 37. X is equal to 37 upon
99.
X is our assumption, so your answer will be 0.37 recurring is equal to 37 upon 99. Simple enough?
Yes.
Okay. So here also same thing, students. After decimal, how many digits are we take? Two. So let me take as first as X. Let X is equal to 15.89 recurring. Multiplying both sides by 100. So what will we get now?
100x
is equal to 100 into 15.89
yes.
Recurring.
1589.89.
15 decimal digits, you will write it further. 89. And then again repeat it. Okay? Now, this is my equation 1 and this is my equation number 2. So, subtracting 1 from
2.
What will we get? 100x minus x is equal to 15.89 recurring subtracted by 15.89 recurring. So subtract now 15.89 recurring minus 15.89 recurring. This will get cut off. 9 minus 5 will be equal to 4. 8 minus 1 will be 7. 5 and so this will be 99x is equal to 1574. So your x will be equal to 1574 upon 99. Okay, this was the fourth one. Yeah. First is same as we have done this all example. 0.7 was recurring. Here 0.6 is recurring. The fifth one we have already done, right? Here.
Rest of all.